A new version of WordPress.org is just out. This makes it much more similar to its competitors like Wix or Squarespace in its ease of building a new website. Today, Alex is going to walk you through how to use the new version of WordPress.org. Just a few things that are important to keep in mind with WordPress.org is that with WordPress.org, you have full ownership of your own site. You get to choose your hosting platform, which means that you choose whatever level of service you actually need. And many of these come with an introductory offer, which includes a custom domain. There are often sales on, and you can get discounts through affiliate partners. For example, we got our hosting for only $3 a month that came with a custom domain. You can also set up a free email address with these kinds of services. A couple of things to watch out for with a WordPress.org site is that with full ownership comes some risks on maybe making your site look a little less professional. You can choose a theme that will help you with this. When choosing a theme, be careful that you're choosing a theme that is constantly updated so that you're not leaving a backdoor open for cyber attacks, but also that you're choosing something that is speedy and helps you to rank more easily on Google. Speaking of that, it's important with WordPress.org to know a little bit more about how internet marketing works. So know what kinds of things affect your search engine optimization, and what's important to consider with a hosting platform. Be careful of too many plugins on your site, as these things can slow it down. On the plus side, many of the builders that come with WordPress.org make it extremely customizable and make it easier to change your service providers later on if you're not happy with how something's working. If you're looking for a website that allows you to make money from the website as well as use it as a marketing tool for your business, WordPress.org might be just the thing for you. Over to Alex.
Hello, and welcome to another video in our series about building a website for your small business on a budget. Today, we're going to be talking about WordPress. WordPress has been around for nearly 20 years, and in that time has made a name for itself as one of the go-to platforms for creating a blog on the internet. Now, to quickly clarify, WordPress is free software. However, it does require a web host, and WordPress.org is the organization's website to distribute the software. However, WordPress.com is a hosting website for WordPress. They are the same software, and you can use WordPress.com if you want to. They do have a free hosting option. We want to do something a little more professional, so we're going to try to get ourselves a domain. And if we look again at WordPress.org, we can see that by going to their hosting section here, they recommend Bluehost, Dreamhost, and SiteGround for reliable, secure, and inexpensive web hosting for a WordPress site. All three of these hosting options have an option to automatically start your account with WordPress already installed on the server that they give you. It makes the setup for it simple, quick, and easy, and it lets you begin designing your website immediately. We here at Millionaire Moxie have used Bluehost in the past, so that's what we're going to be using today to set up our WordPress account and start our new WordPress site. And once we've logged into Bluehost and installed WordPress, this is what we see. You can see here on the left, we have my sites. That's all of our sites that are hosted through Bluehost. To begin setting up our WordPress site, we need to click right here. As you can see from the landing page here, WordPress just updated to 5.9. In this version, WordPress finally added some features that you might recognize from sites such as Wix or Squarespace. It lets you edit your website in blocks, component parts that behave as units on the web page. If you've used WordPress before, you know that most WordPress sites are built out of templates, and those templates still work, but not all of the old templates work with the new features. And I will discuss when I show you how to install a template, how to find which ones work with the new full site editor. So let's begin, shall we? First, we want to come over to appearance and then themes. To add a new theme, we scroll down to add new theme, which brings us to this page where we can find the themes that WordPress makes available to you. You can install other themes from other sources if you find one that you want somewhere else, but the selection of themes that WordPress does give us are quite good. Most of them are free. And in order to find ones that work with the new full site editing, you want to go to the feature filter. Scroll down a little bit and we find the checkbox here for full site editing. Click apply filters, and all of the filters in this list work with all of the new features from full site editing. In order to install one of these, you just mouse over it and click the install button. You can also select preview if you'd like to see it before you install it. I've already taken the liberty of selecting this one here, Alara, to show you how you can manage the themes in a WordPress site. so that you can customize it to your needs and specifications. Once we have our theme installed, we actually want to come over here to the Appearance button on the left menu. Come down to Editor and click there. Once we're in the editor, what we see here is the most basic blog post page. This is the template for a page that a blog post would appear on if you went directly to the blog post. This has already prepared some information to go on the website, which is quite helpful, but we don't actually want all of this here. So for instance, there are too many links in the top menu, so I'm going to cut some of them out right now. So we just want to select the menu by clicking on it, and we can see a small menu appears below here. This will look familiar if you've used something like Wix or Squarespace in the past. Because this is a menu, we want to click Select Menu. And we have some menus here that are already built. I'm going to select our Navigation menu, as the navigation menu is the one that I've designed for the top of the page. You can see that the links up top have changed to reflect the menu that I've created. If I want more options on an element, I can click this gear button here. It pops out a menu from the side, and we can see that there's some options. If we select the post title, we have some styles. We can change the colors. We can change the background color. Because the full site editor is in beta, some features are not implemented yet, like the ability to choose the typeface. But I believe these features are coming soon. Something they added in the most recent version of WordPress is the block feature, which I mentioned earlier. I'm going to show you how that works. You can see up here, the header is a block. If I mouse over it, it highlights the whole thing. Now, if I select the block, I can come to this three-dot menu here and make it a template part. I can name it and designate it as either a general, a header, or a footer. And then I can use that template anywhere else on the website by just dropping it in. As this block is already the header on the website, if we click here to select header, we can edit the header. Any changes we make to this template will be reflected everywhere on the site that this template shows up. This makes it very easy to change the links in our header or our footer and have it apply to every page on our website. We could do this with an informational sidebar as well if we wanted an informational sidebar to appear on our blog posts, but we want to be able to change it out with like relevant updates, news, promotional information, or inspirational messages. To add something like that to our website, we're going to click the plus button up here. Now you can see a menu of all the available blocks, patterns, which are collections of blocks that are pre-built in ways that are already useful to you and reusable, where we would store custom blocks that we've made somewhere else. But for now, I'm going to add a column, and you can see I've got two blocks here that I can put things into. I'm going to take the post content, grab this little handle, drag it inside this one here, and then in this one, I want to add an image. I'll grab something from our media library. If I want to, I can add some alt text, a caption, a description, or I can just leave it as it is. You can see here I have handles to resize this if I want to. I can add a caption. I have some alignment and cropping tools up here. And if I build something more complex to go in that section, I could turn all of that into a template that I can reuse. As it is, anytime somebody looks at one of our post pages, they will see this. The title will be up here, content will be here, this image will be here. To access other pages on our site, you come up here to this little arrow, go to Browse All Templates, we'll select our index, which will be our homepage, and we can see what someone will see if they go to the front page of our website. It pulls the most recent blog post to go on the front page here. And this editor is already showing us what this should look like live with a little bit of wireframing around it to make it easier for us to find components on the page. And we can switch it from the PC view, to the tablet view, and to the mobile view with a simple click. And we can see that the web page is already responsive. It flows to fit the size of the window you're viewing it through. Once we're happy with what we've added, we can go to this button up here. Up here, we can see we have the site. Any templates we want to get to are here. Our template parts are things like our headers, our footers, and finally this button for the dashboard, which will take us back to the WordPress backend. Before we go back to the dashboard, I'd just like to demonstrate how to embed something in a page so that you can use it for all kinds of things, YouTube videos, Shopify buy buttons, widgets for forms from something like MailChimp. The sky's the limit. First, what we want to do is mouse over the space between two elements on the page. Click the plus button. I'm going to add two columns. In the right one, I'm going to click the embed button. All I have to do is paste the YouTube video link in here, click the embed button, and voila, we have an embedded YouTube video already. Now, to make sure that any changes we've made stay, it's important to remember to click the save button when you're done. It will ask you which of the components that you edited since the last time you saved you want to save. So if you've made a bunch of changes, but you only really want one part of it, you can uncheck the other parts, hit save, and it'll only save those parts. And then once we're done, we can head back to the dashboard. A few other things I feel are important to point out before we're prepared to publish this website. First of all, you have the posts menu. This is where you go to write and edit your posts. And to make a new one, you click this button up here. Adding posts is just like building any other page on your site. You'll want to give it a title. And once you've given it a title, any text we want to put in the body can just be typed directly into. If we want to, we can also add blocks. For instance, we can give this post a cover, and then we'll give it some body text. And you can see over here at the right, we have some styles available. These are done by paragraph. Once we have the post written, we can come back over here to post, and you can see that there's some built-in SEO as part of its WordPress package. We can use that if we want to, but in this particular case, it's just an example. So instead, I'm just going to hit publish. It'll ask me some questions to make sure that I'm ready to post. And once it's published, I can look at it, share it, or I can just write another post. Here we can see what it looks like on the webpage. And once we're done previewing this, we can go back up here to our dashboard where we can see we have a tab for media, or we can go to see all the media we've already uploaded. And if we would like to add more, this is the place to do it. Below that, we have pages, which shows us all of the individual pages that we have on our website that are not blog posts. So our About Us page, if I click edit, will let me go and change the content that's on the page. If we don't like the page anymore, we can trash it. And if we want to see it, we can view it. Down here below the Appearance tab, we have the Plugins section where we can manage the plugins that are in our website. It's typically recommended that you not install too many plugins because they tend to make the site run a little slower. It can introduce some security risks. So I would recommend only installing plugins that you trust and that you need. We also have the settings down here where you have things like your site title, your address, your email. The reading tab lets you control what shows up on your homepage in the post section. The discussion section lets you control who can comment, what they're allowed to do when they do comment, that kind of thing. And finally, that brings us to actually publishing your site. Up here at the top, you can see the orange coming soon active. If we click on that, it brings us to this page. So walk through here to help you get your site started if you need to. It reminds you to add a contact page, about page, put more blog posts up before you launch the site. Do some finishing touches before you can finally launch with confidence. And you just click this button here. Now the site's live and we're done. And with that, back to Valerie.
New features make it as easy to use WordPress.org as the main competition, while still giving you the freedom and flexibility of full ownership. This will make generating revenue from your website, not just your business, a better experience in the future as you can tailor your website to what ad providers want. Choose the hosting platform you need for a high volume of visitors, upgrade your design to something even more unique, and so much more. If you're not looking for something as in-depth as WordPress.org, but you need something that helps you along with things like e-commerce, search engine optimization, and other types of internet marketing, check out our playlist here on other website builders. For the biggest competition against WordPress.org, check out our video on Wix. As ever, have fun with it!